Laura Moriarty is an author based in Lawrence, Kansas, and her popular 2012 novel involving silent film superstar Louise Brooks has been adapted for the big screen by Julian Fellows, the creator of Downton Abbey. The author of The Chaperone is here. Congratulations, Laura, and welcome.
Thank you so much, Russ.
You know, your movie opens this weekend in Kansas City, so what's it like seeing your work up on the big screen?
It was thrilling. It was really exciting. The Chaperone is my fourth novel. This is the first one, as you said, that's come out on the big screen. And It was just so exciting, one, to just even watch it by myself. First, they sent it to me just as a link that I could watch on my computer. And that was exciting enough to see all these actors and the beautiful design sets and the costumes and the music. But then to watch it in a theater in New York was absolutely thrilling to watch it with an audience.
A lot of authors complain that the film version is not faithful to their work.
Right.
What would you say?
Well, I knew it would be different from the start, and I didn't have a problem with that because it's an entirely different medium. I knew they would have to change it, and my book is still my book. So I was so happy that I sold the rights, and then I was so happy that it was Julian Fellows and Elizabeth McGovern,
yes,
Mike Lingler. I knew they would do a good job. I knew it was in good hands, and I was more just curious as to what they would do with it.
Why did you decide to make the Chaperone the protagonist instead of Louise Brooks, who was the famous one?
That's a great question. It does seem like the first answer that would come to you would be make it about this icon of the 1920s, you know, this young, beautiful starlet.
The best.
But the more I researched Louise, what I found is she was so smart, she was so beautiful, she had such artistic brilliance, and I would never argue against any of that. I would say, though, you could make an argument if you read enough about her life to the very end. She had a really hard time loving and being loved. I don't know that she was ever capable of that. And my heroine, Cora, is very capable of that. So to me, even though she isn't quite as sparkly as Louise, she's the true heroine. She knows how to love and be loved.
The corset is a potent symbol in this story, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, one thing when I was researching that really drew me to this time period is, you know, hemlines had never moved up so quickly and have never since. Like what women wore, it was changing so rapidly between, you know, 1910 and 1925. There was just so much of a difference, and how bewildering that must have seemed to the women who had come of age just 15 years earlier, like the Chaperone, Cora.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought that would be really interesting to investigate, and how even if younger women were no longer wearing the corset, if you grew up thinking you had to wear it, it would be hard to let it go. And in fact, it was. When I looked in catalogs from that era, they were still selling the whalebone corsets.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Yeah.
Now, you're going to be at the screening tonight in Lawrence, right?
That's right, at Liberty Hall tonight.
Liberty Hall. And what time is it?
It starts at 7. Doors open at 6, and I'll be there to sign books or just say hello to people.
Will you be in a Q&A there as well?
Oh, yes, a Q&A with Laura Kirk. That's right.
And then, again, you'll be doing that at the Glenwood Arts Theater on Saturday night,
that's
right?
That's right. So it plays on Friday in the afternoon and in the evening, and then it plays again on Saturday, and I'll be there for the 5 o'clock showing to sign books or just say hello to people.
And what do you find that people want to know about this when they approach you?
Well, they want to know how I felt about it, you know, how I felt when I saw it. And I really love what they did with it. I think it's, it's moving. It's also funny. I thought the performances were fantastic. And they want to know how it feels, which is just wonderful.
Well, thanks again and congratulations.
Thank you so much.
You're watching Fox 4 News at 8.